Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the fifth episode to create a static website using Bootstrap 4. In the previous episode, we worked on this about block and today we'll be working on this services block. First of all, let's add a new section after this about block, and inside that section let's add a new div with a class called container fluid. Then for this section I want to call it services block, and I also want to add a class called services block as well. Then for this title, let's create a new div with a class called title holder, and inside s2 tag I want to write this heading, and then for subtitle I want to add new div with a class called subtitle, and I want to add my subtitle text over here. Now refresh the site and you should see a title over there. So again, to add this content we can use Bootstrap grid. So just after this title holder you can add a div with a class called row and another div with a class called col sm. And since our design has got 33% width each, we're gonna use col-sm-4, and here we will write our content like this. Now let's add our original content, but before that I want to add my custom class name over here called holder. And then the first thing I want to add is the font awesome icon. So I want to add that icon inside the div with a class called icon. Then for the title I want to add the s3 tag, and for the content I want to add p tag. So for the font awesome icon, I'll just use my developer tool and then simply copy this icon. Also for my heading, I'll just copy from the design and paste it in my HTML code. And I will do the same for the content as well. Now let's refresh the site and you should see exactly the same content block as in our design. Now let's copy 5 of them again. So I will just copy this col sm4, refresh them. And for another row, what I want to do is I want to copy whole row div and paste it like this. Refresh the site again. Now let's copy all the content from our design. Also, let's copy the icon from the developer tool. Once done, you can then refresh the site. And if you compare it to the original design, it will look exactly the same. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on our work block. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.